Hi everyone, welcome to another YouTube video. Today I have some very, very exciting news. 2 days ago, we had some babies, or actually one baby, but now two, of a completely new species. If you know what I'm hinting at, if you've been paying attention to the past videos, we have some new babies from our eastern box turtles. After trying for a very long while, we finally have some babies. They've been incubating for about 54 days. The second one has been incubating around 56 days. So we're going to go ahead, see their parents, and I'll explain to you how everything happened. And then we'll go ahead later on in the video, if you tag along, to see the little babies that hatched out. So come follow me and let's go find their parents. So essentially, the reason I say parents, I mean, obviously there's two parents, right? But the thing about them, or these babies, they're most likely hybrids. So if you know Samson, or all the box turtles that we had, if you know the story, we had them from Auntie Susan, and they all used to live together, which means Samson, the big guy, the big three-toed, he was the main breeder out of all of them, including Wren. That's why I separated them, because I really didn't want any hybrids. But most likely, Samson or Wren is the father, but it's looking like it's Samson. I'll explain why later on in the video on how I'm telling that it's most likely a three-toed and Eastern hybrid. But we're going to go ahead and already check and find some of these parents. So let's see. Actually, hold on. What's that? Can't tell what I'm looking at. What's she doing? Delilah over there. Come over here and check this out. The Delilah girl. She's actually looking for a nest right now. She might be digging a nest. I'm not sure. She was actually digging earlier today. So she's looking for a nest. So stay tuned. We might be getting some eggs from her. But she has some three-toed eggs in her. So this is going to be a very busy year for me. We're having babies pop out of nowhere. So let's find Samson first while we're here. I think he might be in his burrow. Here he is. So the thing with box, actually, take a look right there. See, she's digging her nest. We don't want to bother her too much. She's starting a nest right there, if you can look closely. We don't want to bother her too much. She's not in her trance yet. Take a look at that. Well, isn't that exciting? I wasn't planning for this to happen. She's out here. Oh, this is Vinny. So we have another box turtle. So this is Vinny. He's the co-host. He really doesn't breed with anybody, but he is the nice guy that tags along. You can see how deep this burrow is. I don't feel anything. So Samson, we just come around. He's probably right around here. This guy kind of runs everything. Here, I'll move this back. I had this open for Delilah while she was looking for a nest. Let's see. Let's try and find this big guy. See, it's hard to find these box turtles. You really got to look for them when you try to find them. I don't want to disturb her, but he's probably in here. Sorry, girl. Just looking. Where is he? He wasn't inside the hole. See, you guys are seeing this. I have to deal with this every day. I gotta find these crazy box turtles. So if he wasn't in the hole, he's either along here or along there. These guys love hiding. Even if it's for food, they still love hiding. Double check the hole. Check around here. Do the tap test. See inside that hole. Let's just take a look. Now, he's not one to escape. If he does escape, he goes into the Russian tortoise enclosure, but he probably didn't. Oh, here he is. So, you can see, this kid is always giving me problems, but just take a look at that. So, think about three-toed box turtles, okay? Cool thing about them is that they're known as sort of the dull box turtle, because if you just take a look at Delilah right there, we don't want to mess her up too much. But you can see how she's brown in color. She's not really that amazing in her colors, but she has some really nice colors on her head. If you take a look at Samson, look at his, just his neck in general. If we wet him down, I don't have any water near me, but if we were to wet him down, you can see the colors. You can already see it too. You can see the nice colors that he has. Just take a look at those fiery colors that he has inside his neck. You don't typically see this every day. You know, Vinny over here, he's your more typical male three-toed box turtle. Because they are duller in color, and of course they have the three toes, but, you know, variation happens every day, so, you know, never judge a book by its cover. So definitely any box turtle in general is really beautiful. These are one of my favorite species, actually, just because, you know, you see the kind of sort of dull ones, but then they just surprise you with the colors on their head because they can be covered in dirt, caked in dirt. So you won't know till they're about, till they're a little wet, and then you can finally see the colors on them. If you just look too, look at his plastron, it's nice and plain. Nice orange color. And then Vinny too, he's got some nice reds on him. If you just take a look at that. So, you know, no two are the same. So we'll go ahead, we'll grab him, and we'll find Ren and Stimpy. These two also give me problems because they don't like being found either. So that's a good thing if I can't find them. They're comfortable. You know, you don't want them to be open in the area unless they want to come out in the open. So it's good that they're hiding because it makes sure that they're comfortable and they're able to hide. That's a good thing. So here, over here, we have Mock, ornate box turtle. Before I said she was an Eastern, but I'm starting to think she's an ornate because even Uncle Mike said she might be an ornate. But we'll go ahead and find Stimpy. Oh, I got it. Here she is. Here's the girl. Okay, so Stimpy, she's the mom of these babies. And you can just see, so she is your more typical Eastern box turtle. Not very fancy, but she has some really nice colors on her coastal scutes. And also, she does have pyramiding. This is what her shell should look like. But this isn't what it should look like. This is what you want, but this isn't what you want. You know, she has pyramiding on her, but she did lay two clutches this year, and these babies are hatching from the first clutch. Sadly, the second clutch didn't work out. I already had to toss the only one egg in there because it didn't work out. But, so she's the mom. And we'll go ahead and find Ren, the other possible dad. He's a pure Eastern. So if these do turn out to be pure Easterns, then that'll be great. I want them to be pure Easterns. But if they end up being three-toed hybrids, then that's okay. They'll just be larger in size when they're adults. So here's Ren. Here's your more typical male. If we take a look at his eyes, you can see he has red eyes. So that's the most typical trait in male box turtles. Same thing with Samson. He has almost pink eyes, pink-orange eyes. But never let somebody tell you that only males have red eyes, because females can also have red eyes. I sadly don't have a female who has red eyes at the moment, but they sure can have red eyes. You know, you can search up pictures, they do have red eyes. So you don't want that always to be the key factor. So when someone does say only male box turtles have red eyes, you can always prove them wrong and say females also do have red eyes. So we'll go ahead and we'll talk about these guys. So the main thing about these, so this is your Eastern box turtle, and she's an Eastern. But Samson's the oddball because he could also be the father. Now, the reason I don't know is because Samson, when they all used to live together, you know, you had Mock, Eo, the Gulf Coast box turtle, the Delilah, Vinny. He was the main breeder. When I had them all together while they were still together before I separated them, he would breed with Stimpy all the time. So, you know, it's most likely his baby, but sure could be a mix between the two. So it's really complicated. I'm trying to find out. I'm not going to take DNA results because it's really not a problem for me. The thing, see, you can already come over here. Look, he's trying to breed with her right now. He's already trying to mount her. He's chasing her down already. See, this is what I'm talking about. He's most likely the dad. You know, Ren's, I don't want to put Ren down with Samson because he's going to end up fighting. And we don't want that. You know, it's a good thing for them to fight because it allows better fertility rates and it's also natural for them. But we don't want them to fight because they're not together. So she was mated by Samson a whole lot. You know, Samson was the main breeder. But after I separated them, that's when Ren started coming in. And then he started breeding with her later on. So if anything, these eggs could be Samson's or Ren's, but looking more like Samson since the baby already has only three toes. So now that you guys know a little bit of backstory about these adults and her parents, let's go ahead and go check the babies. So while we walk up, take a look at these two. Lucky and Chugu, like I said in the last video, these two are never apart from each other. You know, they seem to be best friends now. You know, it's weird to say that tortoises can be best friends, but they sure are emotional animals. You know, they can't make facial expressions like dogs. Or they don't wag their tail. or anything like that, but they do form sort of bonds, I guess you would say. And these two guys are very social because they're almost like mini Aldabra tortoises. You know, Aldabra tortoise males will literally rest each other's necks on each other and stay close by to each other compared to like sulcata males where they'll absolutely beat each other up. That's why these two, dude, they seem really fond of each other. You know, I've seen these two in the same house all the time. You know, Lucky's normally a solitary male. He doesn't tend to go by anybody except his mate Taco more often than not. But he's been hanging around with Chugu a lot, and it's really nice to see that Chugu made some friends besides everybody else. You can see he's doing great. So let's go up, and I'll go ahead and see those babies. So now that you guys met the parents, we're going to go ahead and we're going to see this very cute baby. So like I said, this is the first baby I ever produced of this species. You can see that this is the container, and there's actually two now. So if you guys have been following me on my Instagram channel, you guys would have known about her already. You can see here's the second one. Right here, here's number two, Pipping, actually. Take a look at that. Look how small she is. This might be a boy or a girl. I'm not too sure, but most likely all four of these guys are all going to be girls due to the fact they were incubated around 88 days, and this one's pipping at 56 days. So, you can see right here. Take a look right there at the egg tooth. So, if you take a look at that really light white spot, that's the egg tooth that they used to break out. And the thing about these turtles is that you can see how the egg is ripped open instead of cracked like a tortoise egg, because again, these are leathery shelled eggs. So let's go ahead and I'll grab a little baby. Here she is. Would you take a look at that? There is a very cute little Eastern box turtle baby, possibly a hybrid between a three-toed box turtle as well. So you can see very brown in color, you know, not very bright compared to the parents, but you can see how small she is compared to my thumb. Actually, if you just take a look, she's only half the size of my thumb. Just take a look at that. That's how small she actually is. So we're going to take a weight on her. And the reason also I'm saying that she could be a three-toed and Eastern hybrid, like you saw, she is most likely a three-toed because if you look carefully, I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but she almost has three toes on her back feet. If I can manage to hold on her back feet, like right there, you can barely see it, but it only seems to be three toes in the back. So it's most likely she could be a three-toed. Also, she's giving off three-toed colors. No, but we won't know because all of these babies are going to hatch really dull. But it is for sure that the mom is this Eastern box turtle. If you just take a look at her, top of my hand. I mean, look at that face. Look how cute she is. Again, this is really exciting for me because I really have no words. Because this is the first one I ever produced. And she hatched around 54 days. And you can see she's just absorbing that yolk sac right there. A little different than tortoises. She's much smaller. And then you can see she does have the hinge. So we'll go ahead and we'll leave this little guy alone. We'll go over these two eggs. So if you take a look right here, here's this egg. You can see it's already denting in. It's getting really squishy. So actually when I felt this egg, I could feel the baby moving inside. So sooner or later, we'll be able to have this little baby hatch. And then also this fourth one. So go ahead, take a weight on her. We'll place her right here. So try and get a weight on her. Would you look at that? She's only about 8 grams. It's changing a little bit, but she's first weight is about 8 grams. It's a bit uneven here, but she's only about 8 grams. So look at that. If you think about this little girl right here, she has a heart, lungs, a stomach, and everything. And you can already see she's almost taking a little poop right there. So that'll be her first poop. Not necessarily a poop, but it's the remnants of her yolk sac on the inside. So she won't be getting her first meal till right about a week from now. because her yolk sac was pretty big compared to her, maybe around that size. So she won't be eating till about a week. I'm going to move her into her new temporary enclosure. It's going to be like a simple concrete tub, mixing tub, or a clear Sterilite container. And then I'm going to put some cocoa core in there. Nothing too fancy. There's multiple ways of raising these baby turtles, you know. I like to do the terrestrial way. Some people, like Chris Leone, and he has some videos on it. He raises them in water. It's a really good method. You know, it really bulks the babies up. But I like raising them in regular terrestrial cocoa core because it's a little bit more natural for them. You know, some babies will naturally stay hang around the water, like Kohelian box turtles and Gulf Coast box turtles. But I just want them to be able to dig. And also, you know, it gives them a little bit more comfort. So we're going to go ahead and get a measurement on her. So I'll use this. As you can see, she's only about the size of my thumb. So most likely she's only going to be able to, so if we just measure my thumb, she's only going to be able to fit right around there. So what we got to do, you can see, think about it. When she sticks her head in, her head's going all the way back up until here. Isn't that crazy? So just kind of push her head in a little bit. Don't want to force her too much. And we're going to try and get a measure on her. So she's right about 1.14 inches. That's really small. And then her width, so how wide she is, she's only about 0.9 inches wide. So if you just take a look at that, you know, I've seen baby box turtles bigger than this from other people when they hatch out, and they're typically more flatter. But she is one of the longest babies I've ever seen, let alone the smallest babies I've ever hatched here. You can see how active she is too. So small yet so full of life. So speaking about life, she could very well live longer than me. She probably is going to live longer than me. You know, she's only 2 days old right now. So she very well can live upwards over 100 years because this species, all box turtles typically, they can live anywhere from over 100 years. They, you know, they only get like this big. But if she is a hybrid and if she is a female, she's probably going to get much bigger than her mom because if she is a hybrid, they typically get bigger. And also the females tend to get bigger and wider in the as they grow older and mature. So these two little guys and girls, you can already check her out. She's already trying to dig away. Natural instincts kick in. So what these babies do in the wild is that as soon as they hatch, they come out of the nest and their yolk sac is absorbed. They don't need to eat for about a week or two. You know, sometimes even a month because of how small they are. But they'll just immediately go straight for cover. They want to hide because think about it. In the wild, these guys hatch around this size too, but also they'll hatch around redfoot tortoise size, about 20 grams. That's why it's really important for them to find cover and find a microclimate so they can grow that nice, smooth shell. So hopefully, in the future, you guys will tag along, and we can see how she grows over the years along with her siblings and every single sibling that comes after her and all the other new species. So this is another achievement here for me at Hamakua Redfoots. And very well, one of the best achievements I've ever had because this is the first time for me hatching box turtle babies and a turtle species in general. So thank you guys for watching today's video and stick around a while so we can see how she grows up.